It's important to understand the concept of ordinary high watermark because it is the physical boundary of what the Clean Water Act protects. The proposed rule does not change any of the procedures that the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers uses to identify the ordinary high watermark. Ordinary high watermark is used by the Corps to determine the boundary between a water or stream and an upland area. It's essentially the line on the shore or stream bank established by ordinary fluctuations of water. Ordinary high watermarks are identifiable, like in this picture, by physical characteristics. Here, there is a natural line impressed on the bank. Other indicators may be changes in the character of soil, destruction of terrestrial vegetation, and the presence of litter and debris. An ordinary high water mark is created from the regular flow of water. For some streams, this may be annually. In arid areas, this might mean only when it rains. One misconception is that ordinary high water mark can change after a flood event. That is not true. In our example photo, you can see where a flood overfilled the channel. However, you can also see how the ordinary high water mark remains intact at a lower elevation than the flood level. So, how does the proposed rule involve ordinary high water marks? Well, the proposed rule added a definition that uses the ordinary high water mark to identify tributaries. The proposed rule defines a tributary as a water with a bed and bank and an ordinary high water mark that contributes flow to downstream waters. This is important because tributaries are waters of the U.S. and are protected by the Clean Water Act under the proposed rule. That means the ordinary high water mark would be a definitive sign of a tributary that is regulated. Remember, an ordinary high water mark must be visible. If the flow is insufficient or too irregular to create a visible ordinary high water mark, the channel is not regulated under the proposed rule. This definition helps both regulators and the regulated community to consistently identify tributaries by clarifying existing practices. The proposed rule intends to remove the need for case-by-case analysis of tributaries to simplify and shorten the permitting process. Let us know what you think and visit our website for more information.